So last week was the final episode, was the final session of episode 2, all right, which was Tanya Louder's premiere episode. And last episode revolved around the mystery of Jeremiah Kennington, who, as it was revealed, had been struggling after inheriting his father's business, and had been offered a means to save his family fortune by an individual calling herself Hope. She wanted, in exchange, to collect these crucifixes, of which I believe there are two remaining that have not been found, and the four are now in the possession of the party. Three left? Okay, there's three extra. There's three unlocated crucifixes.
There's seven total.
Is there a
special,
so yeah.
Is there a special pluralization for a crucifix?
Crucify.
Really? No.
Well, that's the word.
Crucifixes.
Is it crucifixes? Okay. Yeah. So there are three crucifixes unaccounted for, but and we don't know what they do or why they're special, but we know that Hope, who we assume is associated with prudence and potentially faith. We're not sure about that yet though.
Don't we have to go through and get Piff's spend his XP and everything?
Yeah, Matt, how much XP did I give you guys? At the end of last session.
Seven total.
We had 8 mundane and 3 arcane.
No, eight mundane, 3 arcane?
No. I don't think it was that.
I think it was 2 arcane.
Hold on.
Let me pull it up.
I had 11 total.
It might have been 6 mundane. It was definitely 3 arcane.
It was definitely, yeah, 3 arcane, 3 special.
So it was 8 mundane if it was 11 total. All right.
Yeah.
So actually, you can write that down.
Okay. I did.
Are there any stats on your sheet that you would like to increase? Or...
Yeah, it was 8 mundane, and no, it was arcane. It was two special.
Yeah, but so, we didn't. Obviously, we never spent any when we had the one, so he should be up to 3 special XP.
Yeah, like total XP. From both episodes, you should be at 11 mundane and 3 arcane.
Oh,
or 3 special.
So Pythagatron, are there any stats on your sheet you would like to raise?
What counts as stats? All the skills? You mean skills?
Skills or? And attributes.
Skills and
attributes. Something to help you shoot better.
Yep. Skills and attributes.
We'll see. Firearms is already at 2.
Might I recommend a dot of dexterity?
That would also.
So it was always firearms dexterity when I rolled those?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, then, because I think my dexterity was shit. Yeah, it's 1. How many points do I get?
You have 11 XP, 11 total mundane XP, right, guys?
Okay.
All right. If you want to raise your dexterity by a dot, that will cost you 4 points of experience.
Okay. Well, my dexterity is at 1, so I definitely want to put a point in that.
Okay.
And then I actually would like to, I probably should put it. I only have one in intelligence as well.
Okay. Another, 4 so more points.
So let me put in a point. So a point dex, a point in intelligence. And that's 8 spent, right? But that at least 3.
Skills cost you 2 experience each.
Okay. So then let me put a point in,
And your sheet showed auto-calc how much you have left, too, after you put it in XP spent. So you can make sure you're not going
What's
over.
The max amount of points I can have in skills? How many dots?
The max you can have is 5.
All right, so I'll put a point in firearms, then.
Okay.
So should I actually adjust that in my sheet?
Like, yes, please update your sheet and note the expenditures on the XP spending tab.
Okay.
With the date and how much you spent and what you bought. Trust me, that shit becomes really important, like, way down the line, and you're like, when did I actually up that? Where did that XP go? What's happening? Right, like, you want a nice thorough set of records. I feel as though, like, behind, like, without my being able to see, Plutoferry is probably stirring up some kind of trouble in stream chat. I don't know, because I was talking with Pythagatron and helping him. And I just happened to see the look on Plutoferry's face. She was like, if she had a handlebar mustache, she would have been curling it, pleased with herself. Like,
I need to get like a fake goatee just like yours so that I could stroke it like from Robin Hood Men in Tights.
You know what? You know what? Plutifery, because we established a while ago. I don't know if you remember this or not.
I need to get a fake goatee.
I don't know if you remember this or not, Plutifery, but there was a point in time where we determined that you and I were the same person. Right? And so we need to get you like a mustache and goatee.
I think that would be pretty cool.
And maybe one day you'll be able to storytell A Dark Is Rising. Ooh. And I'll play Tanya.
It's just gonna be tentacle porn.
Fuck yeah! Let's do it! I know how that like, fan service rolls.
The thing is though, Squeege, we did just figure out that Matt doesn't need to spend any XP to make his one arm bigger. He just needs to spend the time of jacking off a lot.
He just needs to spend some time. Just spend the time.
He doesn't need to spend any XP.
For those of you, in the future, when we convert these things to iTunes, which is something I'm going to wind up doing, so there will be audio podcasts, right? So when somebody picks this up, what I want you guys to know that while I was going, I was making the prerequisite like pounding motion with my fist on camera. And that joke would have been lost on you guys listening from iTunes if I had not explained it. And
just now.
You're not safe, all right? I just need you guys to know that just because you're on iTunes doesn't mean you're escaping it, all right?
Those are my favorite chat roulette videos. They got the fucking plate.
All right. A couple of weeks will have gone by. We're gonna get right into this, all right? A couple of weeks have gone by since the adventures. Tanya, you have been... You have been spending most of your time at the manor, as you were gifted a key and a room as part of Kennington's will. Axel, you have been busy between meetings with the mayor, like just bumming, just kicking it back with the mayor, right?
Mm-hmm.
His wife and your wife are now like this.
Okay.
Right, and this is a blessing and a curse, right? They were very impressed with your wife's casseroles.
Yeah, I was about to say, are they sharing casseroles. Recipes or something?
Yeah. Very impressed with your wife's casseroles. Her huge tracts of casseroles.
Her huge, tasty casseroles.
You guys have been having dinner parties. Just the four of you.
And between that and work, you've had a lot of stuff. Like, the mayor has actually, like, your boss was really starting to hedge you out of stuff. Right? And the mayor has now insisted that you be brought in on all, like, the top big cases, and, like, it's a lot of pressure, but you're doing a lot of good. Right? You're pulling a lot of guys off the street, you've actually taken a couple mobsters down, it's feeling really good, you're cleaning the city up in ways you never have before. Right?
Did he get that pimp?
On
that almost shanked Tanya?
But she never really explained what happened there.
Yeah, no, I just said I never really actually went into detail, because that guy got hauled off. Okay, hold up. I don't know where he is. He's probably still in jail. So
point.
And so that's been going on, right? And Levi, you have been watching that rat.
Oh yeah.
Have you been going in for your medicine?
Yeah.
Okay, good. You will start this adventure if you've been going to your medicine regularly, as the doctor instructed. You will start this adventure with completely functional legs.
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Zero levels of lethal.
Normal?
You will look normal.
Oh, good. They look normal again.
The legs aren't beat the fuck up.
Right. Now, I'm specifying you will start this adventure with fully functional legs.
I know. I know.
Tanya, you've been getting to know Jarvis, right? And Judas is he's recovered very well, and mm-hmm. you will actually start helping him pick up his grades.
Oh, that's good. Among other things.
Other than that, you will begin to realize what it is that Jarvis meant when he said that Judas, his hobby was attempting to ski. And Jack! I'm gonna inject something into your character's backstory here, and you can't stop me. you over the years, you know, you're Jack, right? And Jack appreciates a handout, right? And he remembers people who help him out.
Oh yeah.
And people who help him out.
I hate taking handouts, but
right. You know, people who help you out a lot, like very frequently, like you know that one day you're gonna get them back.
Yeah.
Right. And there's a small section of town where that happens a lot. You know, the cashier of the grocery store is is, you know, feels for you. And like when you just don't have the five, right? Nah, don't worry about it. Have a bag of chips, right?
Yeah.
Or like, you know, the gas station where, you know, you get your buddy's car fixed because you're trying to pay off your buddy because you owed your buddy one. Now you owe the guy the mechanic one, right? But, you know, they feel you. They know where you're coming from. And maybe, you know, they'll let you crash on their couch in like the lobby. Like, or like the office when it's like super fucking hot out because it's got the AC rolling there, right? And this diner, if you go at the right times, like they've got the best looking waitresses, right? And they make the best food, and even if they're having a fucking rough time of it, right? Like, you know, they'll cut you some slack or like they'll give you a discount, right? So you've had like, it's all this nice little city block, and you really dig that. You haven't had the chance to go there as of late though, because you've had a lot of people that you feel like, you know, you should be paying off, right?
He's changed his name to Earl.
And so you've spent the past week or two, like, you know, like going by and being like, yo, you know how I owe you $60 at this rate for coffees? Here, man, boom, is $120, right? Like, you're kind of getting some of those debts, and some of them, you know, that feels sufficient. Like sometimes, you know, people who just loan you cash, you pay them off. Some people that doesn't seem to, like, it doesn't feel enough, right? Like you got to pay them back, and it just, you know, money doesn't cut it, because you owe them a lot more. You owe them something, you know, a more deeper emotional debt. Like, you know, they pulled you out of a hard time. They were there for you when the GM started coughing and your character died.
boom, dead, reroll, asshole.
But so that's what you've been doing. Over the next couple of weeks, you know, it's been busy and stuff's going on, but there are no, like, supernatural adventures going on. Tanya, you have seen the strangest of things. You've experienced things beyond mortal ken. Do you share those experiences with anybody? Or do you avoid getting locked up?
I am going to avoid sharing that with my parents, seeing as how they're going to think I'm absolutely nuts.
Right, they already think
that. I will at least, if it's been a couple months,
make the point to check in with Aurora Borealis, my hippie lesbian friend, and just let her know, hey, I'm okay. Like, I know I haven't been around in a while, but I'm okay, I'm fine. I actually got my own place now, so we're cool, and thank you so much for helping, like, letting me crash on your couch. And
No problem. That's great.
Yeah.
But she's hitting on you the whole time.
Well, she knows I'm straight, and I'm sure she's hit on me, and I've been like, nah, Aurora. You're hot.
She's happy for you, really. You know, she's glad you're settled, and
she's probably pretty high when I'm talking to her.
But you definitely get that sense of, like, you know, she's disappointed, but she's not gonna, like, you know, like,
yeah,
she really doesn't want you to go.
We're working on turning you into some sort of lesbian so you can join our group here. But
I was working on converting you, damn it. I took you to Pride and everything.
Aurora Borealis' original name used to be something different. Aurora Borealis changed her name when her parents kicked her out of her house. There's actually a backstory behind her name. She likes the Northern Lights, so she chose that name. So it's not just, no, that's her original name. She had a name change. Yeah, no. She had her name legally changed. I think I actually, hold on. What was her legal name? Hold on, I got that.
She's over there like, I know, right, Pooh? Mine is my date, damn it.
Her name is actually Catherine McDowell. She's now Aurora Borealis. She came out as a lesbian in a high school graduation, and her very conservative parents kicked her out, and so she changed her name.
Tanya actually went and wrote backstories for her relevant NPCs.
For her backstory.
Yeah, she wrote small backstories for her relevant NPCs, and the rest of you should feel like you've been shown up.
Nerd.
Nope. This is also the person who routinely calls you all nerd. You missed it last week, Axel. There was a scene where Levi managed to con the nerdy EMT. NPC. Mm-hmm. It turned out that nerdy EMT was this completely non-functional addict to Dungeons and Damsels, which is this LARP convention organization, and Levi apparently has a membership, and so he offered to arrange like a pretentious meeting between like members of two different houses in exchange for them not getting dragged back to the hospital, because the hospital kind of was filled with demons. Because, you know, they got carried off in the ambulance. It was pretty funny.
Right.
But yeah,
right,
Tawny was drunk as they're conversing, and Tawny just goes, "Nerds!"
It was pretty funny.
Yelled nerds at him.
Okay, so great. So it's gonna be Levi.
What's up?
You're gonna be pulling up to a diner, right? You're hungry. You don't have time to cook. You've got this rat to stare at. You've got business, right? Tonight is not a good night for you.
Okay? I have a question, actually. How has Elsa been holding up over the last few weeks?
She doesn't seem to remember. She doesn't seem to remember any of it.
All right. See, that's an important thing to know.
If she does, she sure as fuck is not letting on to you.
Oh, well, that's completely normal.
But given that you have no idea how to talk to a teenage girl, I'm not telling you which is which.
I wasn't going to ask which was which. Okay, so I'm pulling up to a diner with this rat that I keep with me at all times.
Yeah, you get your rat, and you pull up to the diner, and like, the weather tonight is fucking awful. Okay?
Humid? Hot? What?
Humid. Hot, storming. I mean, like, it's been thundering and lightning. Today's adventure
so
literally begins.
Cool, but it feels
it's
awful.
Very, very frightening.
Very, very frightening. today's story will verily and thusly begin on a truly dark, truly stormy night.
In the Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yes. So you're pulling out, and that's when you start to notice. You start to notice somebody else pulling up. Okay, so Axel. Work, work, work. Zug, zug, motherfucker. Right?
Zug, zug.
Zug, zug, motherfucker. You have been busy as shit. Oh my god, this city needs some cleaning. It's not like the place is like Gotham levels of riddled with crime. But you're a cop. You see all the crime. Right? Like, that's you work in that. You live that. And it always feels like there's something else. Holy shit. Like, you ever seen The Incredibles where they open up with a line, "Can't the world just stay safe for 5 minutes?" Right? It's starting to feel like that. Right, and you get a call. You called into this block in town where there's this heavy disturbance. All right, and it's not labeled as like a super emergency. Just, you know, like somebody said, big commotion, whatever. And you get the short end of the stick, so you get to go tell people to turn the stereo down or stop making noise or whatever the fuck is going on in this area of town. You've never been to this area of town before, though.
Okay.
Like, just, you know, by chance, other people pull this territory. It's not really your turf, but tonight, well, there you go. And as you pull up, like, the storm overhead starts to really crack and rain down, right? So Tanya, you get, you are waking up from a night of rest. Judas has been out trying to ski.
Right.
And so you wake up, and on your pillow, there is a coupon.
Coupon!
It's a coupon for a diner.
Is it a golden ticket?
A coupon for a diner?
Yeah, it's a free meal.
Oh, can this be...
Dude, I'll take a free fucking meal.
So you get a free diner, and like, you ask around, "Hey, Jarvis, what's this? Like, where did this..." He's like, right?
For me, I'm like...
Jarvis doesn't know.
Can this diner totally be Waffle Shack?
Waffle Shack?
Yes.
Waffle House.
I think it should be the interstate hut of waffles.
IHOP.
No, IHOP is not as good as Waffle House.
IHOP.
I don't know.
And
IHOP is not as good as Waffle House. Okay,
my preferred diner.
You just, like, Pluto Fairy can no longer be but... Optical's friend now. Like, that's what I just watched happen. Waffle Shack.
Waffle Shack is so much better.
I like Waffle Shack, where somebody take a note, like, I'm gonna start a wiki for this shit, and Waffle Shack is the place. All
dude,
right?
We can do that on Wikia. Wikia. Make our own wiki.
I've got a nerd wiki, motherfucker.
Hell yeah. No,
I've got a nerd wiki that I'm building, right?
Okay, yeah, well, we can do it on Wikia.
I think I'm using Doku Wiki.
Oh, okay.
I tried it's using Wikia, getting... and we got crunched. It was awful. back on topic, we've got, you're like, well, there's an address, right? And it's only going to be good for another day or two, so whatever, you don't have to study tonight, you got no tests, might as well, right? And as if by chance, now this is the first time you've truly experienced it, right? But as everybody kind of like converges for their own reasons at the same point in the same time at the same place, Levi, Axel, and Jack. Jack, you just happen to be in the area. You're gonna stop by your diner, right? The last two times, the three of you boys happened to be in the same place at the same time for unrelated reasons. Some shit went down, and it was not good shit.
When we all get together, shit gets down. We just need to not be friends anymore. Bye, guys.
So, Tanya, you're getting a ride, right? Jarvis will drive you. Like, oh, totally.
I figure,
you know, you're sitting in the back seat of the car, and you're doing your crossword puzzle, right? Here's what happens, right? You're doing your crossword puzzle in the back seat because you're being rich. This is what rich people do. You're enjoying, like, oh, yeah, this is how it is to be rich. Crossword puzzle.
I'm not taking advantage of a cold record. It's not like I don't finish my meals and I'm acting bratty, by the way. I appreciate the fact that I'm now well off because I was living on my hippie lesbian friend's couch like a week ago. Or I guess a month ago.
I know all about living on couches. You're good. Okay.
Yeah.
So you're sitting there and you got one last thing to put into the crossword puzzle as you're about to, like, as the car slows down. What's a nine-letter word for kill? It starts with an S.
Slaughter.
And that's shotgun? The note that you're gonna get out of your car.
That was a
on.
Very fast response.
That's I can tell that Plutifer has done crossword puzzles, right?
Do you not? I do crossword puzzles in pen, motherfuckers. Yeah.
so that's and oh, you fill it in like that's kind of morbid, slaughter, right? Like and you leave the crossword puzzle in the car and you close it. Hey. There's Axel and Levi and Jack giving each other some kind of look. Like, not again.
Can I do the Grandpa Simpsons, like, walk into the, and then put my hat up, and then walk in, then just turn around, walk, put up my hat up?
Just walk in, just instantly, nope.
Nope. Just walk, no. I'm actually really happy to see them. I probably haven't seen them in a
while. You guys have only seen each other in a week, at least.
Yeah. I haven't seen my friends in a while. Hey, guys. I'm gonna, hi! As soon as I see it's them.
Table for four.
You guys aren't in the diner yet. You're meeting outside the diner.
Oh, okay. Okay. Whatever.
I'm just ignoring you guys. I'm not again. I'm hungry.
So,
walk to the back corner table and
hold your horses.
I forget. What was my motivation for being here?
You were hungry.
Oh, okay.
I've got a coupon for
sure
a free meal.
I wasn't indeed hungry.
I'm not going to turn down a free meal.
All right, so you
got a coupon.
That's yours.
All right, so does everybody have the rights to control their... Everybody should have the rights to control your own character. Please move yourself a square, too. We're going to move ourselves to the fanciest of all the fancies. That? Right?
You select it and you drag it. It's that easy.
I don't think I can select it. I'm clicking on my Boobs McKenzie over here, and it's not working.
Oh, okay. Boobs McKenzie, that is because you did not own your token. Does everybody own your token? Can everybody move?
I own my token.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
All right. So you guys are meeting like up here under this lamp, right?
I can't remember how to do waypoints again.
When you drag your okay, if you drag, I'm gonna use Tanya as an example here. If you drag, and then you hit space, you'll start to measure how many.
That's what it
right?
is.
Right now, and then if you hit space again. Right, you can show which squares you're stepping on like this. Okay, so you guys are meeting underneath this lamppost. Okay.
I can't tell how many spaces that was.
Several.
0 feet, it says.
Millions.
I don't know what I just did.
1 million.
Now the section of town that you guys are in here is not the best. Right?
I can tell.
It's actually looking pretty bad. And I want everybody to roll me a wits plus composure check. This is your perception stat.
Check it. I got hair. Oh, man. I got 4 successes.
I got 1.
Wait, okay. What am I doing?
Wait, what?
Wits composure check.
Wits composure.
Yep.
Wits composure. Okay.
Oh, is this initiative?
Okay,
no,
so.
It's not initiative.
Oh, never mind. Today, guys, I need you to know because I am the GM. Okay, I want my players to not be looking at the stream because I cannot hide everything from the stream.
Oh,
so the stream will have spoilers.
Okay.
Please, I'm giving you guys the honor roll here. All right. Okay. I trusted you guys not to look at the stream. And in turn,
I was totally watching, but only because like I like to see where my.
No, you can leave the stream chat open, Matt. Pop the chat open. There should be a little gear, right? You click that, and you can pop it out. Click the gear and then find the pop out word.
I actually paused the stream.
Yeah, then you're fine. You're totally set. You're totally set.
I thought you meant don't talk to the streamer.
No, the stream chat. The rule in stream chat is that spoilers are a ban. All right.
Damn.
So if it's behind the black space, you can clearly see on the stream, guys. Like this is the covered up area, the fog of war. Do not talk about what's behind the fog of war, so you don't ruin it for the players. All right. And I've got mods that are on top of that.
I will come to your house and I will shit on everything you love, just so you know.
Like she doesn't mean that like metaphorically. She will take a fat dump.
I will upper deck.
There will be a huge
love.
Steaming pile of Kaiba on everything.
Oh my
you
god! I can't believe you said upper deck. That you just became my new favorite person.
Okay. So that said, the territory that you guys are in is obvious. Like it's littered and it's five. and okay. So who got how many successes? Levi got.
Ooh, I suck.
Four?
I got zero.
I got four. Yeah, man. I'm good.
All right. So
I saw shit.
So Levi, here's a couple things that you notice.
Upgrading my composure was apparently a wise decision.
It was, wasn't it? All right, so the first thing you notice, this is blood. The second thing you notice is that the storm has been building, right? And in all of that, like you're not seeing anybody else move, you're not hearing anybody else. Place seems
is the rain
pretty...
actually falling.
Like, does what I'm seeing like it's kind of like zombarific. Around here right now, like
yeah, and like it's got that dead empty like feeling. That for those of you who got a success, those of you who didn't get a success, you're fine, whatever.
Oh yeah. I was more wondering, like, you know, it's just a matter of what's my scenery look like, you know.
I'm seeing what you see here is actually what is happening. All right.
Okay.
So I see blood.
You see blood here, and you see blood here.
Axel, stop moving. I see that.
Axel's doing a dance.
Hey.
Trying to cross over.
Hey, what's going on?
How are you going in a circle?
Hey.
What the heck?
All right, so.
Inappropriate touching. Boobs.
I should have known better than to give you guys Barbies to play with. Holy
shit.
How's
things going, girl? Oh, look at that. You're underneath me, too. Ooh.
Okay. Okay, we're all terrible people.
So immediately upon handing Pluto Fairy anything even remotely resembling Barbies, there was inappropriate touching and sex. Immediately, there was no, didn't even hesitate. All right.
Nope.
You're supposed to be the girl here that keeps us all in check, but no, we're over here like I'm not allowed to touch this.
Smash
it, guys! They're having sex, guys.
Under the lamppost.
All right, I'm sorry. I had to take a moment.
Because we have a whole bunch of people who are new in the audience right now.
Yeah.
If something happens, right, and it really like enhances your experience or it makes the stream memorable and something you enjoy watching. Like if one of the players does something really awesome, I want you guys to shout "beat" in all caps. If enough of you, if the people cry for beats, then I will do this.
Come here, girl. Come to the bushes.
Right. Nice. And that actually earns the players extra experience points. All right.
Yes.
So if they put on a good show for you guys, you can reward them with extra XP. All right. So back of the action.
So I saw blood. What else did I see?
That you saw like the blood, and it's the complete absence of people or life or anything here. Right.
Can I see through the windows of the diner? Are there people in there?
You cannot see through the windows of the diner. It's too dark.
Inside.
Okay.
The
I got one success. What did I say?
The diner
so
seems
the lights
to be
not on in the diner.
No, Jack, you notice that the lights in the diner is this building over here, down this way, right? You guys are actually behind the diner. The front of the diner is further to the south here. It's actually in, check this out, ready? It's in this direction. I got my fancy arrows, right?
Hey, I got that too, down there. Check out my arrow.
All right, so
hey,
you guys
we're on Zombie Road.
Is it actually Zombie Road? Yeah, like, for real? Where?
Oh, come on. It's just a name, like, if the Cave of Hope.
Yeah.
Oh, that sign actually says Zombie Road. Hold on. I gotta zoom the fucking
scene. Just a name like Death Valley.
Oh, Tanya, move. Tanya, move your hand. Stop touching everybody. I mean, everything. All right.
That's not good, guys.
All right. You can also shout beat first for anything you think was really amazing roleplay as well, not just the funny stuff as well. Okay, so you guys are like this. The vehicles locked, windows rolled up.
Hey, girl. Check out my arrow.
And Jack, you notice that the diner seems to be closed. All right.
Great.
Regardless of how long you make that arrow, it's always going to be 0 feet.
Oh. Oh, snap!
Nice.
All right.
Nice.
I couldn't resist. I'm so sorry.
Now with that hopefully out of our system.
This is new and shiny stuff, and it looks amazing. And I just want to say thank you, Squeegee, because I'm sure it took you a little bit of time to put this together.
It took me, I'll be honest, it took me about 3 hours to set the whole thing, and I haven't even gotten to the handouts yet.
That's awesome.
That's right. He's got handouts, he mentioned.
They're so cool.
Yep. All right. So,
what's on them, though?
So, you know, everybody's here. You don't seem to see a disturbance, Axel.
Okay.
But you might have been a little late. Like, the disturbance might have moved on. You might need to investigate and find out what happened. After, I'm seeing a couple of people chatting beat here. So,
does this place seem kind of dead to you? I thought there would be geeks, but nope.
Whatever, let's go inside. I'm hungry.
If the doors are open.
I'm a little worried about what we're going to find inside, because this looks... This is not... Okay, what kind of diner did I get a coupon for? I don't think I need to eat here anymore. I'm rich.
I'm going to start walking towards the front.
Levi will just grab the duffel bag with a shotgun in it out of his back seat.
Okay.
Like, I'm legit just walking towards the front.
How does Axel feel about you just owning it? Do you have a permit?
We covered this in the first session. He has a permit because that shotgun's for his shop.
Over this. He has an actual permit. Okay.
Yep.
Yep. Cool.
Okay, so the consensus is we're going to start moving southward here towards the front of the diner.
I'm already heading towards the door. Whatever door that I can get to, I'm heading there.
Yeah. Feel free to move your tokens wherever your characters are going, right? And I will say pause if people get too far ahead, all right?
Gosh, I'm having a kind of confusing time navigating this.
Where is the entrance to the
diner? It's not that car.
It's okay. So pause
this way.
Pause where you are, Jack. If anybody's going with Jack, you can move to where Jack is at. All right.
Okay, hold on. I think Jack.
Okay, real quick, guys, because we were actually informed of this on our D&D game.
Yep.
If you hold Control and your mouse wheel, you can move up and down. Alt zooms in and out. Shift goes side to side.
Which goes side to side?
Shift. And it's all left side. So if you hold left shift and mouse wheel, you can
zoom out.
Right. Alt, you can zoom in and out. Control goes up and down.
Awesome. Got it.
Or just nothing goes up and down as well. So shift and alt.
You guys are moving here.
And this right here is the entrance to the diner, this little thing here.
Got it. Awesome.
Axel's like,
it's the Z Diner. God, I didn't notice the names when I picked this
one. Yeah, like I'm walking towards the door essentially.
Okay, so Axel, you in front? Is that?
Yeah, I wanted to look inside.
Is that the door?
All right.
I'm set. To me, this place is open. I'm going inside and getting me some food.
Jack wants some fucking food already.
I'm on a fucking mission.
What's some goddamn eggs? All right,
so Pitt.
I want a waffle and some bacon. I want a fucking, like, grand slam fucking grits with some cheese and some fucking coffee.
Careful, you're going to make yourself hungry.
Oh, dude, I already want a grand slam.
All right, so Pith, roll me int plus investigation.
Sorry, what?
Pythagatron, int plus investigation.
Okay.
Oh, I'll also do that.
No, because you can't see in.
Zero successes.
Zero successes. All right, it seems to be fine. The door is open. You can push it and it'll swing open. All right.
That's probably not a good sign. I mean, that if it's.
All right, so hold on, I gotta.
The lights are off, but the door's unlocked. Weird.
Hey, Waffle House doesn't close for anything either.
I gotta.
Even if they're getting robbed, they still have to serve people.
But wow, that's terrible.
That's awful. That's kind of depressing.
Which makes you wonder why there's locks on their doors.
All right, so you guys can step in.
Yep.
At this point, I'm not gonna make you roll. As you step into the diner. Actually, you start to realize why. Way to go, Levi, and putting yourself in the fog of war, you dumb shit. You're going to be over here, you fucking idiot. Okay, so.
Oh my god, it's like my grandmother.
So, as you step into the Raffle House. As you step into the Raffle House, the storm cracks into full fury outside, right? I mean, it is pouring. It is absolutely pouring outside. The wind is howling. The thunder is so loud. The thunder is so loud it rattles the windows. And this is not a place you want to be trapped. You notice how, like, everything here is, like, there's the blood on the floor and, like, some of these, the stools are all ajar and there's, like, shit falling from the ceiling and, like, this place is a fucking wreck. But despite the fact that there's signs of violence and wreckage everywhere in the diner, there's not a single body or person.
I was going to say, can I do one thing real quick and just obliviously just go sit down? Like, Jack is on a mission. He wants food. He's going to go in, sit down, and look at a menu while waiting for a waitress that's not there.
They got one of those hostess bells, you know, the ones you can just tap for ding, ding, ding.
Oh, God.
Yep.
Ding, ding, ding. I hate those guys. Oh,
I'm
God.
I'm sitting at a table.
All right, so Jack, you go and you sit down at the table. Axel, what do you do?
This all looks pretty shady to me. I'm just going to, like, try to walk around and look and see if I could find anything suspicious.
All right, so among the things that are suspicious, you find the entire diner. Other than that, so Axel, you're going to come over here, and I'm going to open up this fucking file real quick, because I took notes. I'm a smart GM.
Does it look like, is there still food?
Yeah, no, like, it's cold.
It looks like people just got interrupted in the middle of their meals. Like, there were people here, but they're not here anymore, and all that's been left. Okay.
Yeah, Levi's just gonna grab some of the food that was left out and just start passing plates to Jack.
Food.
Okay, so
you can eat secondhand food. He's a couch surfer.
That's fine. No, that's true. You can.
Secondhand food. What the fuck?
So you walk
handing me food. I'm like, who are you? You don't work here. Go away. Give me a waitress.
Axel.
What?
I don't think I want to.
So there's blood everywhere.
You walk.
Where? I'm hungry. Sorry.
Leave, I will point at all the blood.
Our own roleplay thing going on now.
Look, this place is clearly not hygienic. I mean, if there's that much blood and they haven't bothered to clean it
up. This place hasn't been hygienic in a while.
Well, okay.
Okay. Okay, so the only people broadcasting the stream right now are Axel and I, because that way I won't get interrupted or spoken over. So,
all right,
Axel, you enter into this section of the diner down here where you're looking around. This is the restroom door up ahead. It's got the restroom sign on it. It's slightly ajar. This place looks like it. There's blood splatter on the walls. There's blood splatter on the walls, and you walk in, and as you know, you start looking around, and you're kind of like rummaging through stuff, and you turn your back on, like, there's a blood splotch near here. Like, you look at it, and it looks like it was actively splattered. It's not like drops, right? Like, somebody was definitely wounded right there. You pick it up and did you give me, is that a investigation check fresh, or do you, roll me a new one, fuck it. Into investigation.
Oh, into investigation, okay.
Aren't you glad you bought that point of intelligence?
Yeah.
All right.
There's one success.
So you definitely, you're able to determine that the blood splatter goes, like, this way, right? As if somebody, it looks like somebody was cut. Like, with a knife or something, right? And then, but that's all you can get from that, so you start turning around. And you start investigating over here, and you find a crumpled up like a piece of paper with some handwriting on it, and you pick it up, and you look at it, and it looks like it looks like a journal entry. There's a date at the top, and before you can actually sit down and read what it says, you know, you start you're looking at it, you look back around the room just out of habit, because you know you're an investigator, it's what you do for a living, and the blood splotch down here actually spells out the words "Help me" in all capital letters. And then you look like, what the, and you look back at the note, and you look back at the blood splotch is normal again.
What the fuck? Okay, I'm gonna go out of the room and tell these guys what I just saw.
All right, so I'm gonna unmute you guys now. If I can find that, there's the unmute, and then there's the unmute, and then there's the unmute. Okay, so,
freedom.
So you walk in and they are having a discussion about whether or not they should be eating the food here.
Okay.
Right. Jack is insisting, no, I'm gonna wait for a waitress. You're not a waitress. Like, honey, there's blood in the food, and Levi is like, I'm hungry.
Like, I'm gonna like put my hand on, sweetie, there's blood everywhere.
What? Really?
Yes, there's blood.
It's normal for this place.
No, I don't think that's normal for any place ever, actually.
Yeah,
so
it's not a good place to eat at all. But by the way, hey, I just saw some
laugh track
blood splatter in the other room, and you might
there's more blood.
Well, yeah, it's just blood, right? But no, as I went to go read a letter, a note I saw on the counter, I looked back, and the blood spelled "help me." And then it went back to normal. I'm not making this shit up. I mean, we went
to... I believe you. You don't even got to explain shit to me no more, okay?
I believe it.
I believe you, buddy. Blood. So, where's the waitress?
Probably dead.
Jack, so, God now damn it. There's no waitress here.
It's the blood. No,
well, where is everybody at?
I don't know.
Probably dead.
Yeah, shit. Put two and two together, man. Jesus. When you're hungry, does your brain shut off or something?
You want to check
sometimes,
the kitchen?
Sometimes. I don't know. Look,
I was going to
say. Let's go check the kitchen.
I agree with Levi.
Levi starts to go towards the kitchen.
Mm-hmm. If you're really hungry, right. Number one, we're going to have food back there.
All right.
That's a good idea. You guys check the kitchen. I'll take a look around.
Okay. Let's go check the kitchen.
Pythagatron and, I'm sorry, Axel, do you read the note?
Yeah.
Okay, ready? Check this out. Ready? Hey, guys. Put bam, and then boom!
Whoa!
Ooh.
Check that out.
Okay. Oh, nice.
Okay, so I'm gonna nominate Plutoferry. Plutoferry, you're gonna be our narrator for these letters, all right?
What is this kiss ask? What? The kid seems...
Okay. Saturday, July 4th. Finally got Alicia to talk to me. She wasn't as oblivious as I thought. She's smart and funny and beautiful. I think I'm going to kiss her. Ask her out on Friday. That new... what the hell is that? Katana Cop. I'm sorry. There's a thingy in my way.
Oh, it's also worth noting. It doesn't show up very well here, but the word "bruck out."
Oh!
Right?
Kiss,
like, kiss, strike it out. No, I'm going to ask her out. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to kiss. That's got the strike through. Ask her out on Friday. That new Katana Cop movie is coming out, and she mentioned being big into comics. Aw, that's adorable.
Never mind.
Katana Cop.
I get way too into.
For those of you who don't know, that is totally a shameless reference to Axe Cop, which is the best thing ever invented. Please go Google Axe Cop and enrich your life. It's a comic written by like a 3-year-old. Or a 5-year-old, and illustrated and produced by his like 25-year-old brother, and it is the best thing in existence. Okay, so back on target.
Okay, real quick, Squeege, is this a doorway down here?
Yes, that is a doorway. Who was going up to the kitchen? If you're going up to the kitchen, go move yourself to the kitchen.
Axel and Tanya are going to the kitchen, or not Axel, but Matt and Tanya are going to the kitchen, and I was going to go down here.
I'm assuming kitchen is this way.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm gonna stay behind gigantic.
So
Levi is actually gonna pull the shotgun out of his duffel bag at this point. Like, I mean, seriously, blood splatters everywhere.
I don't blame you.
All right, so Levi, you gotta open the door there, and the handle is cold, like colder than it should be, and the door is
dark.
The door is locked.
Fuck. I can't. Should I break the door down, or do you want one of you guys want to try and pick this? Really? Usually they're just swing doors so the waiters and waitresses can get in and out easily.
Yeah.
Well, no. If you think about it, that's where the cooks are going to be. The waiters and waitresses don't go back there. They're behind the counter and they get it through a window.
That is
one of those.
Why don't I try kicking the door down? Because, well, you know.
Yeah,
you guys want to kick the rest of us? Yeah, go for
it. All
right,
no, you guys have a blast. Go kick the door down. Have a grand old time.
I don't particularly. I mean, I could kick the door down better than you, but I don't want to do that.
Okay, so
yeah, I don't want that either.
So Axel,
Axel knows what I'm talking about.
All right, so you're going to give it a whirl, Axel?
Yeah, what do I got to roll?
Strength plus athletics.
As I'll say, strength and what? Oh, okay, it's just three.
If it's not obvious, but it's physical activity, it's going to be athletics.
Zero success.
You kick the door.
Levi, shoot the lock doors.
You kick the door. It shakes. It rattles, and then, but it can't seem to.
I think it's locked.
Yeah, I see that.
Shoot it with the shotgun. That works in movies, right? Does that work in real life, Axel?
No, not really. You might have bouncing shrapnel come from the bullet and get you in the eye or something.
Can I try kicking it again?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Clearly, you've never learned about gun safety.
No, I haven't. That's why I'm asking the police officer and you.
All right.
There you go.
One success.
You rear back this time. This time, you really put yourself into it. Pop! Door refuses to fucking budge. You almost fall over.
Oh. All right.
Okay.
I'm expecting that.
It's unopenable. Okay.
Who can pick? Do we have anybody who can pick locks?
No, this isn't D&D. There's no thieves here.
I don't know.
We detect traps. No,
There's no thieves here. He turns to look back at Jack.
Jack.
Yeah.
Jack.
Are you sure you don't know how to pick a lock?
I'm all the way down to the other door. Like, I don't know what you guys are talking about. Like, I'm across the fucking diagonal.
While you guys are doing that, I got something wrong with optical. So if you guys are now done, you're going to turn and talk to Jack. I got to run something with him first. All right.
Okay.
Should have stuck with the group.
Don't you know to dance with the party? Fighters in the back. Fighters in the back?
Yes, actually, that's a good one. Yeah, I will. Because that's a good idea. Like, I'm gonna be actively. Roll it. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Yeah.
What is he doing?
Okay. Two.
I'll tell you what, it is getting hard to keep track of chat, D20, video cameras, like.
Just have it all open. Oh, that's right, because you have one monitor.
I have two. I've got so much attention span, yeah.
Yeah.
Flipping between tabs. I really.
Dodo's got a good point.
I finally see why people have more than one monitor.
Is this a pull door? Have we tried pulling the door open?
All right.
I'll just put it out there. Dojo's got a point. Have we tried that? Like, I'm assuming when you pulled the door, you try to push and pull. I'm hoping. Or right. You try to open a door.
Yeah, I did that.
So, off the way. So, Jack.
Yeah.
Jack, you step in here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like so. And you find. You find another journal page. The office seems to be not a site of bloodshed, but a site of a real struggle. Right, like the chair is spilt over, and like there's papers, and like the pencil cup has been knocked over. The drawers are like ajar. Right, like it. You really get the sense that this is going off. And as you know, you had activated your sense as you walked in. Right. And I'm gonna step away from the microphone so I can give you like the most immersive sound I can here. Ready?
Okay.
The sound that you hear in your mind is something along the lines of "God, no! Oh God!"
Okay.
Oh, does Jack jump? Are you like freaking out over there?
Oh man, he's got.
I think he's.
Jealous.
Jack's suddenly gonna he's gonna become like, oh shit, like there's something going on. Can I tell what direction that's coming from or no? Or is it like just
it's in your head.
Yeah, no, I get that, but I mean like
it sounds muffled and like hazy and smoky, like it's got a slight whisper to it.
Okay.
It doesn't have directionality, which sounds should, right? Like you should be able to tell where the sound is. You can't.
Can I tell if it's coming from inside the building or no?
No.
Okay.
Like he's going to be that nice.
Okay. And there's no other door in here or anything like that. This is just like a little office.
Right.
Okay.
Is that what it is? It's an office?
I would assume it's like the manager's office, essentially.
You'd think that'd be in the back.
Okay. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and walk out and kind of be like, hey, did y'all get that door open?
No, can you pick a lock?
I can try. I'll give it a college try.
Jack, please. You know you pick some locks in your time, man. Come on.
I have, but it's been a while. Look, we can't talk about it, all right?
Like riding a bike,
not with you here.
Go try it.
I'm not going to admit to anything.
Listen,
but
I'm pretending I'm not seeing anything. I'm going to this room right here.
We're gonna try. I'm gonna take a good look at this door, and then I'm gonna try and pull, like, open, like, wiggle the handle.
Oh, man, look at this interesting plant
and see if
it's not gonna just open like that.
Plant over here.
Okay. What?
Look at this plant.
She's distracting. Keep working.
Well, yeah. What am I gonna feel a little weird about, like, people watching them? So.
Why are you looking over my shoulder, man? Gee, come on.
What are you talking about?
Door, man. I'm just talking about the door.
It's a great plant.
Hold on, that's a bee. That's definitely a bee.
Why are you looking over my shoulder like that? I'm just. It's a door.
This is a good looking short bush.
That's amazing.
Oh, man. This
over here. It's a good looking short bush. We're going to talk about some short bush, me and Axel over here, while somebody does some illegal things. Let us know.
From across the room. Yeah, you know, they do good in low sunlight. You just got to keep them damp.
Yeah, Matt knows. He's Googled short bushes before.
And by Matt, you mean Levi.
Yes, Levi's Googled short bushes. He's jaggled that short bushes
before.
Yeah,
go ahead and give me like a dexterity larceny check.
Dexterity larceny?
Yep.
Oh, for some reason, okay. I thought you said LARP City, and I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, I thought you said LARP City, too.
But you're the one with the membership to Damsels and Dragons, all right?
Two! I got two!
So here's what you realize. When you go to jiggle, and you do a little jiggle, and then not clicking. Like, it should, you know, it should have that, like, satisfying, like, but it doesn't happen, right?
Right.
That's when you pull away your, like, your little tongs and your little pokey things. Right, from your, whatever they call them, the lock picks, right? And you realize that the door's not locked.
What?
But it's not opening either.
Correct.
Oh. Well, damn.
Okay. I'm not going to say that, but I'm gonna get up and be like, hey, Levi, you got your shotgun, right?
Yeah, I got my shotgun.
Blow that fucking handle off.
This is so
you don't
bad
see
idea.
Anything. Don't just case stay. Just keep looking at the bush. You're fine.
If they're gonna blow off the door, I'm getting in the manager's office.
It's a bad idea.
Just do it. Just blow off the door. You're fine. You're fine. I'm gonna hide over here. You're fine. Just shoot the door off.
You don't just shoot the door off.
Just shoot. No. You okay? Look, man. All you gotta do is.
Hey! I want to hear what Pythagatron is saying real quick.
Okay.
Blasting a metal door at point blank range with shotgun shells probably will result in you opening up more.
Yeah,
hey, listen, I've seen it done in the movies. It's okay.
No, it's not.
I'm gonna hide over here then.
I have a question. Grant, are the hinges on this side of the door or the other side?
They're on the other side.
Damn it! That's not surprising.
You can't I see what you were gonna jack spare. You were gonna Pirates of the Caribbean out of that cell.
Hell yeah.
That was gonna be pretty awesome. Okay.
Wait. So this is a door. There's a window right into the kitchen that the waitresses come to pick the food up from.
Nope.
How the fuck does this restaurant work?
The door opens.
No wonder it's not in business.
The door opens.
No. That's how the restaurant works. Oh, is they open the door.
I just had a little.
I don't believe you anymore.
Okay. Well then, what's over here? I'm gonna put my boobs off screen there. There, okay. What's over here?
Okay, that is the restroom.
Oh,
that
that's
door right there. That goes to the restrooms.
Okay.
Nobody has been in there yet, but the door is slightly ajar.
Okay, you know, can I knock on the door? Like, I'm gonna.
Oh my god!
I'm kicking it like
hey,
a bunch.
Hold on.
They didn't know if that was zombies or people.
Oh no, it's okay. Never mind.
Like, I did an intelligible rap, you know, like shaving a haircut, but I didn't do the two.
Basically, you were like, blah! Right? And Levi was like,
shave and a haircut.
Yeah,
well, we know it's not a tune back there.
Well, there is no response for you, Levi. Tanya, are you actually going to investigate the restrooms? Or?
Honestly, it seems like these guys got that under control. Unless, do you want to go in the restrooms, or I'll go in the restrooms?
This door is out of control. The game.
Is it a ladies only restroom?
Hold on a second, Squeege. You need to change your game. We're not playing D&D.
That's true. It does say it. Oops.
Although to be dead set, I see every role playing game stream ever just use Universal title for their games.
Yeah, it's just role playing,
and it's the only role playing game that has any traffic at all.
We got dice. We got roll 20. It's tabletop.
They really should just like make a universal tabletop thing, but yeah, like I was surfing earlier today. Right, and I found like three or four streams. I found a Dark Heresy stream. I found a Roll 20 Modern stream, and I found a Rogue Trader stream, and they were all just labeled Dungeons and Dragons.
Well, then screw it.
Yeah, so just leave it D&D, especially since D&D actually has people investigating. Like,
Luigi,
that's fine.
Yeah, okay. So,
can you imagine how big the Universal Dungeon Master's Guide would actually be? I mean, come on, if they smushed it all together,
fuck yeah!
Oh my god, it'd be amazing. Okay, if nobody else will, I'll do the thing where you stand in and like swing the door open wide.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's got pie cut. She's gonna cut the pie.
Yeah.
All right, so you're gonna cut the pie. Jack, did you go back down here for a reason?
No, I was thinking I was gonna go in there and look for keys to the door, but then I realized that what you told me is, that the keys wouldn't actually make any sense.
Yeah, since it wasn't locked, we can't help,
Okay, so, Tanya, you see back here, like, there's, it's not that the restroom is particularly clean by comparison to the rest of the place, right? Like, this is obviously out of order. There's no blood splatters, but it also looks like there was some struggle going on in here as well. And there is some kind of, like, note page with, like, handwriting on it. Like,
go figure.
Right.
Okay.
Right here. You can't read what it says from over here.
Grant, I have a question, actually. Are there security cameras in here?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to go to the office then, and I'm going to try and log into the computer and look at their security footage.
Okay.
All right. You said there was a piece of paper on top of the toilet?
Yep.
Or on top, like, it's not in the toilet, right?
It's no, it's on, like, the back.
Okay, good. Right there. Good, because I ain't reaching no toilet.
Careful, somebody might have upper decked that son of a bitch. I've done it to this place a couple times, just saying.
I'll pick up. You are responsible for the downfall.
So you go in, you go in to pick up the, you go in to pick it up, right?
Yes,
and at that point,
no.
As you enter the restroom,
somebody grabs your hand.
The goddamn tentacle.
The door slams shut behind you.
No.
There is the sound of it locking.
Oh.
And then somewhere in here, like somewhere in a stall, you can't see. You hear like a really loud pop and a hiss, and this like a pipe breaks, and the room starts filling slowly with water.
Oh, I'm trying to bang this fucking door down as soon as it shuts. I'm like, all right,
toilets is
bullshit.
No.
Okay, so
and
Tanya,
I'm charging into this fucking door.
So let's roll initiative. Tanya will take the first action. We'll go around so that we're not talking over each other. Everybody, roll me initiative.
Yeah.
I have a question. I was in the office. Did I hear that even happen?
No.
Yeah, it's the bathroom door, not the bathroom stall that locked. The bathroom door that locked.
Yes. Okay. So. Okay,
initiative. Hold on. I need to figure out a thing.
That was Axel got a 5, right?
Mm-hmm. I got a 5 as
what
well.
What is? Okay. I'm sorry. I always ask. Wait, initiative is. Yeah, it's my own button. That's why I always get confused, because it's its own button. I'm on a 14. Well, shit, son.
Damn.
Super fast, apparently.
Go ahead and put yourselves on initiative order here. Enter your own initiatives on the initiative counter.
Where's mine? You didn't put mine on there. That's
you didn't roll.
I didn't roll because I'm not aware.
Yeah.
I didn't hear any of this happen.
Okay, so Tanya, you grab the paper, and as you grab the paper, right, the pipes burst,
top of the hour.
And the place starts filling up with water. All right, you only have at the rate that this water is filling, like really fast.
Mm-hmm.
You only have a couple of minutes before you are dead. All right.
What's going on with those boards in the middle stall?
The toilet is out of order, so we're gonna leave with you almost drowning, like in this dire circumstance for our top of the hour break. Don't touch that dial, guys. We will be right back after these messages.
I refuse to be your cliffhanger. We are handling this now.
Oh, too bad. You are the cliffhanger.